Welcome back. You're joining me in time for Operation Blind Night. This is a swarming alien abduction in Mendoza, Argentina. It's September, so we can probably expect some nasty enemies unless this is an eco round for the aliens. People have got their gloves on, they've got their carapace on, and we're ready to take this A-team squad to the danger zone and back again. Let's get down there. Let's see what this swarming abduction is going to be like.
Roger, Big Sky. Reading you 5x5. Strike One has the green light for deployment.
So for this operation, I'm generally just gonna... I think I'm just gonna burrow under the ground here and just go submarine mode. And then we'll basically build a dwarf fortress, if you will, within this mountain. We'll strike the Earth. Probably dig too deep and too greedily. Summon some ethereals and chrysalids, bosses, and that'll be fun. In all seriousness, we're not going to tunnel out of this wall as cool as it would be. Imagine if your KSM mechs, right? Imagine if fist mechs could dig into the ground and then, like, use their fists to dig and punch out like moles, like mole men. Point being, what we're actually going to be doing on this mission is moving to the right, securing the upper floor first, then the lower floor. The way this works is like two roadway maps in one that are shorter than usual. So instead of one long roadway, you've got two roadway slices right next to each other. Because of the way elevation blocks line of sight, and of course the train blocks line of sight as well, you have free rein to just focus on one slice at a time. So whichever slice you start on, you're probably going to want to focus on that slice first, obviously. That's the easiest way to keep contact isolated. Once we've secured the top, we can then take good cover and begin raining fire down on the lower half, or we can just overwatch camp the higher half. If there's too much contact, we can fall back. If this is secure, we have this as our home base, and there's a lot of options from there. So that's generally the idea. I have got a read on a meld canister around this position, but meld at +3 a canister is going to be a secondary concern in a swarming abduction, because we could get some nasty contact, and you've got to be careful. So we're going to move it out towards that hut. We're going to take that hut. We're going to go from there. Go Frag-E. Discover aliens. Not like NASA. Like Black Mesa.
Moving out.
Alright. Let's get into this.
Copy that.
We bias for that right side first. EQ's got line of sight to it.
Look out!
Scubaman in position here. Yavoy indeed.
Bin unterwegs.
The lovely Renzol here to snapshot hard.
Heading to that location.
And Hunter
heading
here as well.
That location. Roger that.
This is why they call EQ Emo, because he's always far away from everybody else. It's a term of endearment.
Okay,
he's always off sulking behind a rock, is how they figure. Can't believe it took me that long to realize that's why the nickname fit. That, and of course, I assumed it was actually an emotional thing after the regret he had. It probably was. Probably a mixture of both. We got mutons down on a low ground, I heard. What do we have high ground? Berserkers. My love for you is like a truck. We're going to need to chem that. But of course, getting too close to chem it is its own problem. What was back there with it? Was it a drone? Excuse me, like check tape as usual. No, it was a floater, and that's why it's good to check these things. Alright, so we can acid them. They can't blood call because they haven't got regular mutons, and I don't believe standard berserkers can blood call, so we can acid them and fuck them up a little bit. But we must respect cover because of that floater. Maybe we should just fall back, hit him on a round of Overwatch first, then worry about taking him out next turn is probably the safest possible option to take. Anything else just seems too risky. And with Scubaman here, we have got a great squad to go for Overwatching these guys, so that should be more than safe.
Ben.
More than safe, extra safe. Ultra safe.
Moving to position.
Fail safe. We will we should put a chem in the way. Oh, they might go around the left side if I put a chem in the way. Are they that smart? I don't know.
I'm on the move.
How smart are berserkers? Will they just run through it? Probably not. It seems like they'd be smart enough to not do that. Let's just, let's just move back. Play the safe rather than sorry game. 10-4. That should be well out of range. Dad, we're well out of range.
I feel, Commander.
Play the Overwatch game. This is going to be a bit safer, hopefully. But it does mean we're running out of space to deal with them, of course. Okay, he went that way anyway. It does mean we're running out of space, of course, because we're backed against the wall here. So it means it kind of forces us to deal a lot of damage next turn. But I still feel like taking advantage of the Overwatch is going to be better. We are going to have to deal a lot of damage in this next turn. A absolute ton. So far, we're not hitting much at all. We're just wasting a lot of ammo at this point. God bless, ammo conservation is going to be very important here. Wow, this is some poor Overwatch shooting right now. Luckily, close combat's going to do some good work here. Nice. Good stuff. Frag-E, look out. It's behind you and it's angry. Okay, now what are these ones going to do? Same thing, same thing. Hey, he tried to bull rush the air. Oh god, fuck, he's gonna bull rush me. Holy shit. You can't do that, I'm behind a shiv. Jesus. Oh, what the fuck. You see, fuck bull rush, you see? That floater could kill me if he's close enough now. I thought, there's no way he's gonna be able to reach Renzel all the way back there. But I was wrong. Fuck bull rush. Should have chemmed him. Should have trusted them to be dumb and just run through everything. Please don't kill me, Flutter. Thank you. Is that gonna put Renzel in the goddamn medbay? Son of a bitch. You little shits. You little fucking shits. Okay, well, we're gonna have to fall back a bit. We're gonna have to set up this just right because all these guys have to die. All these guys have to die.
Okay. Look out!
So it's gonna be chem to start. Chem them all. Yes, chem them all. Yeah, bias for the front ones because that back one's already wounded. Fuck Bull Rush, man. That was 6 damage that I should not have taken. But again, you know, if I'd thrown the acid and they hadn't run through the acid, they could have just come around and killed Hunter too, you know, like... And the acid wouldn't have stopped them from that first move, so... It's hard when you haven't got, like, bombardier range on your acids. It can be a bit tough, I think. Reload. And we're going to have to start bringing them in here. That's right, I was going to shred next, of course. Just try not to shred Frag-E if you could. Mind the paintwork. But apart from that, you're cleared hot, Renzel. Fucking berserkers. Renzel got punched the fuck out. But she got him back. She's going to panic now, though, because that is 3 intimidates. Whoa, Renzel is a tough little lady. My game can't even handle it, but Renzel did. I probably should have taken my shot of EQ first before the range penalties got too bad. Maybe I can pull one of them away. I'm gonna kill one of them with Scuba. Then Overwatch of the other 2 shots. You wanna rapid fire the big guy? Yeah, you wanna rapid fire the big guy? Rapid fire the big guy. Fuck off.
Bye-bye.
Fuck off. Oh shit. Get him, Drake. Get him, Scuba Man. Easy.
Adios.
Now we gotta watch that floater. One of the problems with engaging you in this fashion with Drake is the floater, if it's smart, could now get a flank shot on Drake, but she's got the health to handle it, is why I wasn't too worried. In fact, more scarily, really, is Renzel could get unluckily shot at a half cover here. Nothing we can do about that now, though.
Overwatch. Aye, aye.
Let's just hope the floater doesn't see her. Ooh, good shot from Scuba, though. Renzel's a decorated veteran. And it looks like she'll be okay, thank God. That one's not even flying. There's no animation, it's just... Okay, what's that noise? More berserkers. Climbing ladders. Climbing stairs. No, that was stairs. We've got him on the stairs to my left, I think. Right here. This is gonna get even worse. We need to heal up Renzel with that EQ kit ASAP. And meanwhile, we gotta track down that fucking floater. There he is. Oh, come on, can no one get him? Why can you see him but not engage him? What? You just squad-sided for Scuba Man? What? I don't understand how that works, but okay. I mean, if you say so.
Heading to that location.
Alright, worst case, I can flush him if Scuba Man misses, I suppose. Fuck, I'll just flush him from the start.
Rousing him out.
You know what's gonna deal that 2 damage. Renzel's gonna need some healing assistance from Iku. And we're gonna have to prepare because it sounds like more pods might be on their way. So again, with one of our 2 kits down, because we travel pretty light on kits, we're gonna have to watch out with Hunter that he doesn't get shot down, or we're not gonna have to a revive. So we have to be very careful for that.
That's affirmative.
But we also gotta watch out for these incoming enemies. Hold your position, Hunter, at the back of the element. You can dense smoke from there. Iku's little emo rock. Iku and Hunter just poking their little heads up over the rocks, surrounded by berserker corpses. Very cute. Okay. Let's go up the right side, actually. There they are. You got a berserker on the goddamn roof. It was a ladder. Looks like 2 floaters, 2 mutons, and a berserker. I'll give you a guess who the priority target is. So that is 4 and 1. I need to turn my light on. I can't read my dice. 4 and 1. We'll pull back Frag-E if we can to avoid unnecessary hits. Now the difference here is we should be able to handle this without needing to waste a lot of consumables. Oh man, I can even move up and close and counter shot it. That's really cool. Or
moving.
Even better, hit him. Fucking hell, Iku.
Target still up.
Not the day to start missing, guy.
Commander.
Can you bring this guy over? Yep. Yeah, now Renzel's not feeling it. There's a nice free shot. Now we're gonna get Scuba Man's shots going. He is shredded from, hello there, Stolly. He's shredded from Drake. Sentinel. Fuck. Hold your position, Sal. Just stay right there. Does anyone have holotarging who hasn't used it? I doubt it. I don't really take it. Unless I've got a scout. So we'll just rapid fire. Alright, it's gonna be down to good shots from Scuba Man to clear this up nice and conveniently for me. Come on, Scuba. Good start. First mission back on the job, Scuba's like, what the hell are these things and why are there so many of them? Alright, and he's coming. Love that screenshot. Just totally just chilling there. Okay, Hunter. Ah, Hunter can't see him. Buggy bub 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 bub. Oh yeah, Stoli's got it. Wait, no, Stoli might reveal to the left if I move there. Can nobody see this damn thing? Stupid heavy cover. I'd rather hunker Drake versus all this shit, so it'd be better if I could hit this with Stoli. I'm sure it won't activate. I'm sure it'll be fine. There you go. Get out of here, kid. Get out of here, scrub. Let's get Hunter up into the fight, where he can dense smoke and... actually, no. Gotta watch those flitters, don't crit him out of nowhere. Let's keep him at the back, take my own advice. We'll hunker Drake to keep eyes on him without fucking ourselves up. Frag-E can hide in between the barrels, and that's a wrap. Current dangers. God. That is a Muton and four floaters, I think. I hope it didn't activate. That is not what we need. We have to push aggressively through this contact if we're getting ambushed on our left. You gotta fight through contact. And it would really make it tougher. No, we didn't pull that left pod. That's good. We can take this a little bit slower. EQ, try not to miss this time. I'm gonna give you another shot. We don't know about covering fire, but we do know the Mutons don't have it. If I take out the Overwatch, Frag-E and Drake are going to butt-buddy this whole scenario. Get him, Jay. What if I get some grenade on first? Reckon that's possible? Curses.
Se me está acabando la munición. Maldita sea, el enemigo sigue vivo.
That's a bit better, isn't it? But still got a fucking floater facing me down. Renzo's still freaking out. Fuck it, shoot him. Next time I'll start with you, Cell. My mistake. Down to three enemies on the board. Still got some Overwatch to deal with here, though. Get him, Iku. Not quite, buddy. How's your arm, Hunter? Not quite good enough. I wanted to smoke Frag-E. I feel like it's still worth the effort to get them all. You know what I'm saying? I feel like it's still worth the risk here. We're just gonna run the Overwatches with Frag-E because that's what Frag-E does best. You feeling lucky, punks? Oh yeah, I'm not even going to the mech bay yet, fucker. Yeah, you better be feeling lucky, punk. You better be feeling damn lucky.
Good to go.
Because once again, oh my god, the alloy shiv providing step out cover can give you just the best fucking moves. Just the best fucking moves. Kill that shit. Not bad, man, not bad. You could do better, but not bad. Oh, I'm providing that cover, shit. Of course I am. I hate when that happens. I hate when I provide these damn things cover. Nah, it's not worth moving now. Of course I'm providing it cover. Stupid, stupid. Can anyone an assist? Nah, no one can get an assist in. Oh, we're gonna be so careful moving on the right too, not to activate those guys. I think we'll just hold where we are because of that. So it's all down to Frag-E and Drake. That floater's gonna flank me because it can fly, so we have to deal with him. These two are gonna run, so I'm gonna get close encounters on both. That's two shots. Probably finish off... Nah. Wait, yeah. No. No. Yeah. Shit. Haven't got enough ammo, fuck. One shot too few to make both these close combats work. The mutons are certainly scarier though. But I have much better odds to kill this thing. So maybe we'll just engage this. And I'm gonna shoot you. Don't panic, cuz. Uh-oh. Now that's bad.
I wanna go home.
That is poor. That is exceptionally poor. We're going to need to move into support, even if it's just a showing of support. Damn Shiv giving the muton cover. Oh no, go away. Fuck. Contact left. Jesus. Good hunker. Actually a good hunker right there.
Go hard. Go hard.
Okay, contact left. Medbay for Frag-E. Five on the left. You're doing good, Frag-E. You're doing real good. Whoops. That was actually a misclick. I meant to press E. Still probably a good move, though. Time to murder. You need to save Drake. Hard. Actually, Stoli's got it as well. But you still need to save Drake. Oh god, you're in view of that muton too. I don't like that. Save Drake. Damn it, Iku.
Out of ammo here.
Today is a really poor fucking day for you, you know that? Alright, Stoli can still help us, I think. Still, he's gonna have to break cover for this one, but gotta do it. She should be blocked by the gas pumps here. It should be okay. Meanwhile, don't give the muton cover again. Just kill him this time. That's more like it. The loss of crit really punishing as happened to us that time. Now we'll want to move Renzel around to Rocket. Probably shred this turn, take the cover out next turn. Yeah, it's looking pretty scary, isn't it? Let's get some dense smoke rolling, make it a little bit less scary.
Up.
Yeah, you stand on Pride Rock. The bodies of his brothers, his red brothers, surround you. He should know not to come at you. Okay, Scuba's got to get into cover.
I'm on the move.
Hit him with the shred. Ah, it's a fucking shitty shred. Just get ready for the shred. Get ready for this shreddy. Fucker's coming straight in. He's got dense smoke. Jesus. Oh my god. Scuba. Scuba's got no cover. Oh god, that dense smoke might save us. Stoli! Picked him off through the line of sight. That was a good grenade from that fucking muton. That was danger close. Now Scuba with no cover. Things looking pretty scary. But Drake's back in the fight, just not with a lot of ammo. Don't think that's gonna keep her out of the fight, though. We really needed that rocket against all these damn floaters. We're gonna have to keep the dense smoke going over here. Dense smoke's gonna make it really tough to kill this fucking muton. Drake's gonna have to move to this position, I think. Run and gun here. Probably not even worth taking a long-range shot with Frag. You're probably worth just using him as cover to get this shot. Ooh, but I can't really. Okay, okay. Frag-E is gonna have to draw fire. That much is assured. Meanwhile, Scuba's gonna have to move into... into there. We'll send all these floaters and hopefully I'll creep them out enough. Damn my own dense smoke. Damn me and my super effective. And I gotta watch out too, because I'm gonna actually have to cover Stoli, I think, instead. Instead of what I was gonna do. Which means a lot of Overwatch to run with Drake if this goes wrong. I think she should be okay if I run to here. I think I should have line of sight block.
Going in for the kill. Location confirmed.
Yeah, you better get that kill. And you better stay alive, Drake. Nasty hit. Dodge the rest, yes. 20% to crit because of the damn smoke. But it's not like we got any better options. You're gonna have to hit him. Good job critting. Now that guy has to get finished off. But how? Cell can fucking deal with him, I guess. Maybe. Nah, Cell hasn't got an angle on him. Scuba's gonna have to deal with him? Shit, this is scary. He should run, right? Because he's fucking all kinds out of position. Scuba in so much trouble too. Can I even afford to leave him there? I have to. I have to. Maybe I can move out here, finish off the muton. I don't know. It's not good. It's definitely not good. I think you're just gonna have to rapid fire one of those floaters. One of the close ones. Oh, Scubaman. Scubaman, man, stay alive out there. It's a fucking war zone out there, Scubaman. Stay alive. I shouldn't have smoked the other side of the car. It was an accident. Sorry, Scubaman, man. Okay, cover that engineer. We're gonna take out these front runners. God, there's dense smoke everywhere. Can't see for all the smoke.
Got it covered. We're green to go.
Skewman's gonna have to cover, man. Nothing else to do. He's gonna take that 50% that the muton doesn't just sit there flanked and shoot him. Meanwhile, we're gonna take the 50 on this guy, I guess. The double rapids. Covering fire! We're okay. Convert it. Convert it! Good job. Sentinel. Your move. It's all down to this muton. Down to how crazy he is. Oh, please kill him. If ever you had to hit Scuba, Scuba! Damn my own dense smoke. Oh god, that floater can just go straight for Scuba now with no Overwatch to scare him, and he's gonna know it. Scuba that floater! Oh god.
No! I wanna go home!
Ayuda! Que alguien me ayude!
Jesus. Yes, hunker. Your squad's putting it on the line for you guys. Time to put it on the line for your squad. One of them had covering fire. It might have been that one. Well, while we're in the smoke, let's hit one of them. It was that one at the back. It's gone now. Yeah. Shit. Okay, Iku. Let's see here. Maybe we'll start with this. What do you think, Renzo? Time to kill some floaters? Maybe it's time to kill some floaters. Alright, we still got problems with that one on the right there. But that's a good start. Guys need to be taken out ASAP. Could hit through the suppression, but Iku won't kill that one. Alright, to be extra safe, we're gonna have to smoke Scubaman one more time. I know it's making us run out of smoke, but he's gonna unhunker and then even suppress that back floater's gonna fuck us. So we're gonna smoke with Hunter. Which means we may as well go for the flush on this one. And the laser sniper on the last one. Unless I can disable him. Disabling shot would make it. I don't have to waste the smoke. It looks good. No, fuck. Gotta smoke.
Halting enemies advance. Adjusting aim.
Yeah, you fucked up, that's what. Can't even see them in the smoke, I guess that's the point. Throw that smoke out there.
Clouds away.
Okay, we're gonna be okay. We're gonna be okay. I'm gonna be okay.
They gave me a position.
I'm on the watch.
Oh god, it's just drones. Oh god, he's coming in for Drake. Watch it. Drake's pretty low. And Scuba. Drake, watch out. Oh, okay. Sure, shoot Frag-E and heavy smoke. I'll take that. Take whatever you're giving me right now, guy. That was a scary fucking move. Now we got drones coming in. We gotta watch out for them. Yeah. Fair enough. You've had a pretty traumatic time. I'll give you that one. But this floater has to die. There you go. We got drones coming in. We need to secure ourselves here. Good God! What a fight!
Headed there now.
What a fight! Scuba's gonna have to hunker there. Go out and draw fire, Frag-E. They're robots like you. Just keep them off us.
Roger that. Scanning.
Roger. I've got my eyes on.
Fuck me, are we actually gonna live through this? Maybe.
On my way.
Maybe. Maybe we're actually gonna make it through. I guess those drones didn't even activate? Good, I thought they activated. Didn't they? Are they? Are they active right now? What is going on? Let's go with they're not. We need to get you in the best possible cover, Scuba. You're in no position to fight. I know you want to shoot drones, but you are not in a condition to fight right now.
That's affirmative.
Paso ligero.
Ready to rock.
Timber.
Let's do this.
Good to go.
Nachgeladen. Locked and loaded.
Come on, drones. Let's mob this one up. I got a lot of medbay personnel paperwork to file. Maybe come to you, huh? Alright. I can dig it.
Aye, aye, Commander.
Groovy.
10-4.
Verstanden, Commander.
So not ending my turn out of cover. So paranoid that that is a bad idea.
Rolling out.
So paranoid they're gonna activate and kill me like the Seekers. Not doing it. Let's get some healing for someone. Actually, that revive might be necessary. Let's get that revive.
Moving to Overwatch.
We could just send Frag-E out there and Robot Thunderdome it.
Moving.
Robodome.
Go. Okay.
Roger, tracking.
Ya voy.
Ya voy. Just okay. Just hold your shit.
I feel, Commander.
Come on, little drone, let's do this. Let's get this over with. Robot Thunderdome. Four little drones came marching. Hurrah, hurrah. Shit. There's his buddy, though. Hurrah, hurrah.
Heading to that location.
Hurrah, hurrah. Oh, that's interesting. That's interesting, you can't quite rock it properly. There we go, that's better. Okay, take out some poor passerby's cars, I guess.
Estas.
Not fucking around with drones on this mission. Hurrah, hurrah. Taking way too many wounds. Fuck fighting these goddamn drones. No way I'm gonna let them fucking crit me. Nice.
Kill
mission accomplished.
Tough break, tough crowd, tough mission. That was rough. That could have gone really badly, and it all really went wrong. If you ignore the bull rush from that stupid berserker at the start, it really all just went wrong because of that failed intimidate roll with Drake when she was close encounters gunning those mutons. Really all came down to the fact that I forgot I would give that muton cover by moving to it. I don't know if I could have set it up and still got the flank otherwise, but it probably wasn't optimal. But out we get with everyone alive, and that's the important thing. Hey, your plane's here, Urban. Days out for Stoli, pretty bad. Surprised she got picked through that line of sight, but she's lucky to be alive, I guess. Scuba out another 8 days, he just got back. Frag out for 5. Frag-E. Renzel out for 5. That's going to slow her meteoric ascent to Master Sergeant, unfortunately. She must be close. Still, we did okay to come out of that one alive.
We will be in touch, Commander.
Alright, here's your new bird. Your new bird's ready, you fucko. So we gotta wait till we get his laser cannon ready. He'll get a second shot. Meanwhile... what was I building before all this? That's right, I needed alloys for carapace, didn't I? That's what I was building. Yeah, it's all good though, we're all good. Probably use an additional scope or two. If I've got the money spare, which I do. And we really need to save some alloys for Gauss too. Maybe I should cancel these new additional carapaces, I don't know. Like, we're not gonna have enough alloys, is the problem. We're not going to have enough alloys for the freaking Gauss weapons. How much are they? Let me look that up. Hang on. I need to look up how many alloys I'm going to need from all my weapons. Yeah, we're looking at around 12 alloys per Gauss rifle. I'm thinking I'm going to cancel these extra carapaces. I mean, it's good to have for the base defense, but we don't know when that's going to come. And honestly, having Gauss weapons is going to be more crucial to the base defense than 2 extra suits of carapace, which I may or may not need depending on how I roll. I don't know, I feel like I should get started on my Gauss, maybe. It's going to be more important. And I'm going to need those alloys, unless we luckily get a landed large ship in the next 9 days. These alloys are going to be exceptionally necessary, so I think I'll delete and get these alloys back, because I'm going to need them. Really running out of alloys here. Someone asked, you know, why don't you make a second alloy ship? And you can see even already, we're really just running out of alloys, you know, like, you can't afford that. You cannot afford to just spend all your alloys. Okay. Well, that's that. Whoa, didn't I just cancel the carapace armor? Yes, why is it still... Okay, there it goes, it's updated. Yeah. So... we're gonna carry on, I suppose. We're gonna scan for exit in a couple days.
Contact detected.
Where are you going, and what are you? Are you a large? Are you landing?
Bangs out.
Are you going to give me lots of alloys?
No joy here.
You could be. Or you could be a Terra ship over Australia yet again. Looks like it's going to be Terra.
Contact detected.
Okay, but here's a raider. A raider of the Lost Ark. I reckon we can take this. And we need the alloys desperately.
Engaging.
Plus, it'll probably bring a destroyer in if I don't shoot it down, so let's go for it. Just gotta watch the crits.
Closing on target.
Yeah, armored fighters. I forgot all about my new shit.
Disengaging.
Jesus, that was close. I think I figured out what it was that got my interceptor shot down last time, and almost got a shot down there, except for the split second. Is the difference is if you click abort after the shot has left the UFO, I think it's too late. But we got out of that one okay. Barely. Okay, so we've got a crashed medium. That's good, we desperately need the alloys. I will gear up a standard crash medium squad, you will wait. And we'll get onto it. We just gotta skip 1 hour for AWO. Alright, like I said, you wait, I'll handle it. Okay, another nice, fairly vanilla squad here for captures. Of course, a medium is slightly harder than a small, so it makes even more sense to bring higher ranked troops. But again, in this case, we're mainly trying to go for promotions. Goddamn Renzel, take a look at this shit. Renzel within a pathetic 2 XP across the entire campaign of having hit a Master Sergeant on that mission. Unfortunate. but what are you going to do about it? So hopefully that doesn't end up being something that decides the fate of the campaign, her not being a Master Sergeant. Hopefully nothing big shows up before she's back in action and goes on another mission to get that Master Sergeant rank. But as for the rest of us, it's the same as always with these UFO missions. Captures, meld, bringing home the bravest sectoids we can find. Instincts tanking. Organs leveling up to be another Master Sergeant Rocketeer. We're leveling up Hypergeek. We're leveling up AWO. So we skipped for him. That's really it. Kung Tot hasn't got Carapace. He's just got Phalanx because we just built Phalanx. So he's got some kind of weird thing going on. He's just baring his arms. He's just getting some sun. Look, this is really pretty standard. Let's get out there. Let us do our best. Let us bring us home as many captives and meld as possible.
Dropship has arrived.
The area of engagement for this mission will be in India. The UFO came down in a sparsely populated area away from any major population centers. We can secure the site with limited danger to the civilians in the area.
Alright, Operation Lone Heart sounds great. I should mention too, I took rapid fire on Zim as opposed to double tap. I'm gonna have medbay and perhaps kamikaze as my double tappers, and then Cell and Zim as my rapid firers. That's the reasoning there, in case you were wondering. But otherwise, I've talked about the perks against each other, I think. Anyway, back to what I'm actually meant to be talking about. Operation Lone Heart. Join me for it next time. Until then, have a good one.